and had a war here for 38 years, even though the word war was never used by the British government, because you can't, if you accept that there's a war, if there's a war, it's a mutiny if there's a war in Britain. So with words like the troubles, the conflict, with many words except war, because war cannot be used, because war within Britain would be seen, as I said, as something like close to mutiny. As the Armagh, I think specifically, is unique in that it's 50-50, you know, in terms of religion. But then I was thinking, you have to be very careful. You cannot generalise, because you can't stereotype no religions, because not all Catholics believe in one thing, not all none believe in something else, you see. So, but certainly, it was this town was severely damaged by the troubles, and in fact, the surrounding area was, because Armagh County, South Armagh, would be seen notably Republican, and North County Armagh would be seen as notably Unionist. It is inevitable that people's standard of living, people's quality of life, job creation, employment opportunities, wealth within Northern Ireland, because the Republic of Ireland has increased tremendously in terms of GDP and wealth creation and job creation, and the North, I think, can learn from that. The North can see that that's happening, and I think over time, when people travel, people integrate more and travel more, the old stereotypes that existed are now breaking down very, very fast. And people now become a bit more mature in their thinking, and realise that things aren't as narrow, aren't as black and white as once people once thought.
People fight like. Let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, study.